that there was going to be a way of doing that, that we're going to offer support to them. And there's actually five areas that you've got to commit to as a school that you need to do before you can get a certificate to say that you're a fair trade school. Those five areas are: you have to set up a fair trade school steering group with at least half, which is at least half pupils, so it can be some staff and some pupils, but at least half of them have got to be pupils from that school, and they've got to meet at least once per term. You've got to write and adopt a fair trade policy for your school, which has the support not only of the head teacher, but of the board of governors. So it's got to be across the school, the whole school's got to be committed and signed up to this agreement if you're going to get this certificate. You've got to use and sell fair trade products as much as possible, which can be within the staff room, it can be at tuck shops, it can be trying to get your school canteen to use maybe orange juice and things like that. Obviously, not selling chocolate bars every day in schools now because the way things are going to change, but you can have occasional treat tuck shops, but getting it within any areas within the school that you possibly can. And then you've got to learn about fair trade in at least three subjects in two different year groups, which means it's not just about the icing on the cake, the nice times, the break times, the lunch times. It's got to be part of your school curriculum. So you've got to have different year groups for your school learning about it and covering it in different subject areas. It's not just for the RE, it's not just for geography. You've got to be looking at it in different subject areas across your school. And then the final one is you've got to take action for fair trade at least once a term in school and once a year in the community. And that's where things like Stephen mentioned John Griffiths, who's our Christian Aid retired teacher who goes into schools and talks to students about it. That's getting the community in, or you can hold a community open day, or you can invite people in. You can invite them in for a coffee morning. Various ways that different schools do it. And what they want is schools to be creative in the way that they look at fair trade within their schools, getting the students, the pupils, to come up with their own ideas. Now, we're really lucky in Warrington. We've actually got three schools that have managed to become certified, as have gone through all these steps, and you've got to do it over a year. You can't say, like, this week we're going to be a fair trade school, and we'll do it all this week, and then that's it. You've got to send in proof over at least a year's worth of trying to become a fair trade school. And we've got three schools in Warrington who've become fair trade schools. The first one we're going to hear from tonight in a couple of minutes is Cinnamon Brow Primary School. They were actually the first primary school in Warrington, first school in Warrington who managed to become certified under these new arrangements and actually proved they met all these criteria and are a fair trade school. And they've renewed, is it, you know, your third renewal or second renewal? Second renewal, so they're renewing now for the second time. They've managed to keep it going because they don't give it your fair trade. They don't say, right, okay, you've got your fair trade, that's it, go away, call yourself fair trade. You have to renew it. As a fair trade borough, we have to renew every few years, and as a fair trade school, you have to prove that you're still doing all those things that you're doing. So Cinnamon Brow are just in the process at the moment. They've sent off all their stuff, but just waiting for it to be renewed through to get it the status again.